If you're not using the Trello mobile app as a part of your project management experience, you may be missing out. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And in today's video, I'm going to show you a number of tips so you can get really, really comfortable with the mobile version of Trello. And we're going to get things started off with remembering that we can create new boards directly here from within the app. Now, I realize that most people do not start their journey with Trello in the mobile version. There's a good chance that you first signed up and use much of the Trello services and features from a desktop computer. But when you need to start a new board, don't forget that you've got this green button here in the lower right-hand corner when you're viewing your boards, when you're in the default view here on the main page. You can select that green button and start by creating a new board. I'm just gonna call this one New Board 2 sample there. I can select and I can assign it to a particular team if I want, or I can just say no team and select create. And there we go, we've got a brand new board. So when I've got a new project or I wanna dump some notes into Trello, often I'll start off with a fresh board depending on what that project will entail. Now that brings me to my second tip here, and that is the importance of selecting an appropriate background and also starring our boards as well. Let's start with by picking an appropriate background. As I scroll through my large collection of boards, and you might have a large collection of boards as well, it's important that you pick either a color or a distinctive image so that you can easily access this. So if I go back to this new board which I just created, I've got the default Trello blue here. But you know what? Very quickly, I'm going to be adding a number of lists and a large number of cards. The blue background isn't going to matter so much, but on this screen, it is going to matter when I want to go and find it. So when you're within your board, in the top right-hand corner, we've got the three dots, which are going to open up the menu. And about halfway down, we want to select our board settings. And here, about the fourth option down, we have background. So I'm going to select background, and I can either choose a distinct color on the left, or I can select a stock photo. And in many cases, I encourage people to select a stock photo. Now, you can search for something up in the top right-hand corner. You can search for a particular image. In this example, I'm just going to pick something. This is kind of interesting here. What is this? Jellyfish? I'm going to select this jellyfish one here. And then I can go back. It will be applied here to my board. Again, I'm probably not going to see much of this image when I'm working on the board, but when I come to the front here, it's going to make it stand out a little bit more. Now, the second thing I want to encourage you to do is don't forget to star certain boards. When we go to our home screen here, here you can see I've got about 7 boards that I've starred, which essentially pins them to the top. So these are going to be my most frequently used boards, the ones I want to be able to access all the time. So if I open up this new board 2 sample, I'm going to select menu once again, and just below board settings, we have star board. I'm going to select star board, and if we go back to the home screen, there you see New Board 2 sample is now as a part of this collection. So don't forget to star the boards that you need access to most quickly and picking a unique color or a unique image so that you can quickly and easily grab those boards. Just for example, you'll notice I've got a home improvement board here, and the image I've chosen is, you know, a hand with a bunch of color swatches. It's pretty self-evident that that's a renovation or a home improvement board. I don't even have to look at the label anymore. I know which one I want to select. All right, now let's go into another one of my sample boards here, and I want to give you a tip about searching and filtering cards on mobile, because you can do the same things that you do on the desktop version here in mobile. If I select the magnifying glass in the top portion of the screen, you know, I can enter in a keyword such as task. And now I can see all of the items that that have task in their card title or somewhere within the card. And it even helps me out by giving me a number to the left. So in this case, it's telling me there are a total of 3 cards with the word task in them. But you can also filter cards by other ways. One of the ways I like to do it is by member. So if I type in the at symbol here, in this case, I'm the only one who's assigned to this board, so I'm the only member that comes up. But if I had other members a part of this board, they would also come up as well, and I can find them. So I'm going to select myself in this case, and I can see that there's 7 assigned to me. Let me just hide my keyboard, and I can scroll over. Now I'm only viewing the cards that are assigned to me. So I use this a lot, filtering cards down so I can only focus on the things that I want to. Let me close that for a second, or I should say cancel that particular filter. The other one I use quite frequently is filtering by label. And to do that, you want to enter in the number sign. And here, everything, all of the labels that are applicable to this board are going to be presented to me. And let's say I just want to look at urgent cards. I just want to work with urgent cards right now. I'm going to select urgent. It's telling me that there's only 5. I'm going to hide my keyboard again. And now I am just dealing with those cards that have the urgent label attached. So beyond just a text search, don't forget that you can also filter by members. You can also filter by labels. All right. Now, the next tip I want to show you is how to take a picture and attach it directly to a card. Because let's be honest, our mobile phones tend to be more of a camera more so than anything else. And when you're away from the office, you're away from your desk, you still might want to take a picture or grab an image of something and put it within a Trello card. So I'm going to open up an existing card. You can obviously add a picture to a new or an existing card. Once I'm within the card itself, in the bottom right-hand corner, we want to select the green button here. And we're given 2 choices. We can either add a checklist at this point, or we can add an attachment. We want to select attachment. Now, the very first option here is take photo. We can do other things, such as attach a file from our phone, link it to things like Google Drive or another link. But in this case, we want to say take a photo. I'm going to select that option. It's going to open up my camera. I'm just going to pull back for a second, take a picture of my microphone. And Trello's going to say, hey, does this look okay or do you want to retry it? I'm going to say that's fine. That's fine for this example. Let's say okay. And now you can see it's attached that image directly to this card. If I want to tap on the attachment itself, I can click on it and see a bit of a bigger image if I want. And if I have card covered images enabled, you can see now that when I'm in the board level view, I can see that image on the front as well. So don't forget that you can take pictures and add them directly to any card. It's quick and it's very, very simple. Last but not least, I want to show you how to get information into Trello from another area of your phone, such as a web browser or maybe some other application that allows you to share information. So let me just exit here for a second. I'm going to open up my browser here, and let's say I've come across an article. I've come across a blog article, and I'd like to reference this for later. I'd like to come back to this, so I'd like to add it to a particular Trello board. Well, in the top right-hand corner of my browser, I've got three dots, and it's going to give me some other options. And the one that you're looking for is share, whether it's a web browser or perhaps some other application. So here you see share about halfway down. I'm going to select that option. And on my phone, it gives me a few different options. The first row are some of the people that I've texted with recently, so maybe it assumes I want to share this with them, but I've got many other options down below, including to share it via social media, Gmail, or a variety of other apps. But the one we want, of course, is add card to Trello. I'm going to select that option. And what it's going to do, it's going to give me 2 choices here. It says, well, first of all, which board do you want to add it to? And I want to add it to the one that we were in, my Scott's Tasks and Projects. And then the second dropdown is which list within that board do you want to add it to? And in this case, I am going to say to-do. And now, last but not least, I'm going to select create in the top right-hand corner. It's going to bring me back to where I was, which is great, because maybe I do want to read some of this article right now. But let's go back to Trello, and let's go back to that board, for example. And if I go to the bottom of my to-do list, there you will see that article, How to Find a Trustworthy VPN. And it's got the link there, so I can click on the link and go directly to that webpage. So yes, you can easily share and get information directly into a card, into a Trello board, when you are browsing or doing other things within your mobile device. I hope you enjoyed today's tips on getting the most out of the Trello mobile app, but I'd love to hear from you next. What do you think, and how do you use the Trello app to be more productive? Be sure to leave your comments down below in the description. I want to thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you subscribed right here to the Simpletivity channel. Give this video a thumbs up, and don't forget to leave me a question or a comment down below. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.